Hey, what it is, your boy Stilo Magolide, and we're about to go in my DMs podcast. Yes,
First of all, welcome to, you know, my DMs podcast. We just got Stilo Magolide up in the building. He's like, nah, fuck this. I'm coming in. So, yeah, the time is money, you know what I mean? So, the conversation goes down like this. French Fry says, MTV gives you a list initially of like 100, 200 rappers, right?
It's a long ass list, bro.
So then from then they start funneling it down to get to number 10. So my question was, what if you want to nominate a rapper that's not on that list at 100? What then happens?
Alright, cool. So I guess none of us asked that question.
Okay.
So I was actually like, so explaining. So it's a long list. Everybody gets it.
Okay.
You choose your own top 10
from that list.
From that list, personally.
Got you.
Then you submit it.
Okay.
Everybody submits it.
Okay.
And then they put it in some like system, and then that system draws up these random, I don't know, like
is it
a looks
computer
like,
system or what?
Yeah,
what
it looks like it's a computer ass system. So we get on stage and we all chilling and Tsikho is there and they're telling him according to that whole list how it worked things out, who number 10 is. Then we start debating from there, like, no, but how come?
None of us.
The only thing you know is your top 10, the one you chose.
I guess they obviously put like
algorithm or something.
No, not even an algorithm. We'll put maybe a list of 10 things. Let's say, for argument's sake, 10 things that are a must to define like a good year for that particular artist.
Got you.
And if you check those 10 points, then maybe you qualify to get into that. To that ranking, and then based on numbers, because it can't be based on actual rap skills.
But then what I want to know, what is the metrics? Because we need to understand those metrics.
He said, in terms of the list, right?
Yeah.
You as a brand, as Stilo Magolide, they don't just look at Stilo the rapper. So to the public, it's MC, because we're looking at bars.
Got you.
It's in a business way. They're looking at criteria.
Intangibles. How many brands you got? What influence in hip hop?
Your reach.
And you must remember, you're dealing with a new time. It's a new wave where it's you're dealing with cats that are like doing crazy numbers digitally, but don't exist on a street level.
100%. That's my chat.
That's a fact.
That's my chat. Hence what I'm saying. What if your dude might be clocking like 300k listeners, streams on like SoundCloud, but you're not on that initial 100. Now that I've got a problem with that.
Facts.
Yeah, but
I've got a problem with that.
I think it can't be also judged, like there has to be a separate category for like a SoundCloud rapper, because you're dealing with like DSP rappers, like sales.
You're dealing with
Spotify, like subscribers, like people.
Okay.
I paid to listen to you.
Okay.
You feel me?
Okay.
It's not my friends in my classroom that like my shit.
Are you suggesting we should have like another sort of second hottest MC online?
That's on y'all if you want to do that.
That's for us.
I think in 20 hip hop 24/7.
No, it's important.
Yeah.
Because that's what it's about. Like, if you guys as the community of hip hop, do that for those kids. You're giving them the gas to then want to work hard enough to get onto those other lists.
Facts.
Okay.
For the cats that want to live that life.
Facts.
You know what I'm saying? So, because you get rappers like me that I don't care about a top 10.
Really, bro?
Nah. His era is not.
Why? Right. Okay, hold on. Why?
It's not even about lists. It's like, for me, it's like I'm number one in the streets.
Got you.
And that's season after season. That's regardless of however you can bring your hottest, and then you bring me, and we do a national tour and we see who's hot.
But Stilo, how do you define the streets? Some people will say online is the streets.
Basically, streets is the people.
The streets is the people. Yeah.
But where do you find the people? Online? Is it clubs?
No. Doug, there's Mandela and there's Steve Biko.
That's
it. And if you know your history, you know the difference. You know what I'm saying? Like,
you
gotta be like, I'm ground level.
Okay.
You know what I mean?
Got you.
Like, I got fan base, car guards of my fan base.
Got you.
You know what I'm saying?
Got you.
If you're gonna say you're street and you scared to walk in certain spaces anywhere,
I got you.
I know there's places that are dangerous that I wouldn't want to go.
Okay.
But I know if I touch those places, I bet you one or two people in those streets would recognize
you. Let's address something that you say. You were quoted to saying in the streets. Now, in 2019, there was an article that quoted you saying that you said Amapiano is killing hip hop.
Yeah.
Do you still feel like that even now?
I mean, you must understand that amapiano as a genre will always will be 10 times bigger than hip hop, just in the sense of it that it's a mixture of two things that hip hop can't deliver, which is dance and rhyme.
Rhyme, really, Stilo?
Yo, these cats are rhyming. Youngstaner's rhyming.
That's a fact.
These cats are rhyming.
You know but killing is a very rough word to say in hip hop.
But that's how severe it is. So much so that I bet you $1 million that in his heart, in Focus heart of hearts, he wished that he was in New York doing a hip hop show.
Mm.
You know what I'm saying? Like in his core heart, like maybe he would deny it now because he's always wanted to be a rapper.
Rapper.
The dress code, the combos, the
combos, hip hop.
But you know, but the reality of it is that what got you there is not your rhymes. It's this dance music genre, but we're also a dance nation.
Gotcha.
That's something that people don't understand. When people ask me, what type of artist are you? I'm an urban artist. I've always been an urban artist. What's your format? I rap. That's my format, but I'm an urban artist. That's why since the beginning of my career, I've done so many different genres.
Mm.
It's not based on like, yo, I want to have the hardest 16 bars. That doesn't make a difference to me.
Here's my opinion on things, right? Forbes said something, aka said something very key. He's like, okay, cool, amapiano's killing things now, we understand. But can amapiano last for like 20, 30, 40 years? Which hip hop has done. And I'm not too sure about amapiano killing hip hop because it's hot right now, but it hasn't proven its longevity to me.
But that's what they said about hip hop. That's what they said about hip hop. When hip hop started, they said, you guys are not going to do it. Like, you guys with your baggy pants, American accents, won't last. From that, we created lifestyles. We did basketball tournaments. We empowered a lot of kids. We saved a lot of lives through this hip hop thing. You know what I'm saying?
Got you.
And then my piano saving a lot of lives.
Got you.
Through this piano thing. Like, you know, it's bigger than, like, the dreams are more severe.
100%.
And I mean, like, dog,
it's real life.
It's scary.
It's like, real life.
You're seeing, we saw cubs at a small first, you know, I'm sure, in a back room.
Yeah.
To in a big house and the designer every day. You get what I'm saying?
Got
like,
you.
These kids are looking and saying, you guys are rappers, it's dope, but like,
hey.
You know what I mean? There's cats like Boyz and Blxckie, there's cats like Cash Time, there's cats that really maybe showed you that, yo, it can be done like this and you can get some money, you know what I'm saying? Casper, you know what I mean?
Gotcha.
You can get some money.
Fear family.
But most of the hip hop community ain't living that life.
Mm.
Do you get what I'm saying?
Straight.
Most of the hip hop community never touched designer shit.
Straight.
Most of the hip hop community never been to Diamond Walk.
So hip hop is broke. Amapiano make your money.
That's not what I'm saying. But I'm saying that the reality of it is that sometimes what hurts the most is that the cats that start some shit won't be the cats to reap the rewards of it, right?
Okay.
And that's what happened with a lot of cats in hip hop. You know, a lot of cats that started shit never got to reap the rewards of it. So the cats that followed through did different moves and popped off different. Piano, same applies. Like, that's why there was a huge debate about cats like Stokey, like, who's the originals, you know?
Mm.
And they then got their flowers and then they started eating like they deserve to eat, you know?
Ladies and gentlemen, my DM podcast, I want you to comment. Comment section, we need your opinions and thoughts on this matter. Stilo, look, bro, on that, you know, on that reel, on that cats that started but never got to see it, The Voice, Hadebe. I know you got a tattoo of him.
Yeah.
R.I.P.
What was your relationship? And what inspired you to... Tattoo is a different level of love. That's like forever on your body.
Yeah.
What was the relationship?
It's family, man. Like, little bro. Little bro, big bro. I mean, like, one thing about this game, about this life, about this industry is that it's so easy to get caught up, and it's not even about getting caught up in the lights or whatever, it's just getting caught up in whatever the fuck you're doing.
Gotcha.
You know? And you need people around you that can give you peace of mind, you know? I always believe that in my circle, I always keep somebody that's my earth, because I'm the electric, right? I'm moving. I gotta have somebody that's my earth that I can always tap into. that doesn't move on the frequency that I'm moving on, 100%. You know, to ground me. And Vio was always one of those cats that he'd balance me. You get what I'm saying? Like, we'd be moving, but he'd know, you know what I mean? We'd, and as a unit, like, but between myself, Vio, Young Stilo, you know what I'm saying?
Gotcha.
The trio was, we'd always balance each other. You know what I mean? Nobody would move. Nobody would get too big for their boots in whatever the fuck they're trying to do. And that's, you know? And, you know, created like a unity that was different, man. That's family, you know? And that's forever, you know? So I guess for me, like, and more than anything, I'm hip hop.
Got you.
You know what I mean?
To the core.
I'm hip hop. So when niggas die, we either scrub you on, you know what I mean? We scrub you on our flesh, pour some liquor out, and we, you know?
The man. You know, we one of the realest podcasts, so we ask questions that come from the streets. No, we are.
It's my DS definitely. Podcast.
I don't even flinch when you ask me that question. You know.
Yeah, but dog, you guys, how are you guys like the realest one in dog and it's hip hop? You niggas ain't even got drinks in this bitch.
Hey man, look, we got
this. You know what I mean? We could roll you something, you know what I mean? We could always roll you something, do whatever.
I'm not gonna smoke when
Man, we send out the emails, man. You know how the game works.
We
send out the emails,
we
brands.
My guy, UDC, I'm trying to speak to the corporates now.
But as a street man, as a street nigga, at least have some mud for a nigga.
As a mud for a nigga. We got you. Like, sorry, I apologize on behalf of the podcast. We gonna hook you up.
Did you guys see the interview with Burna Boy? Like, how you bring me on the Daily Show? Don't even offer me drink.
No drink.
That was a fire comment.
You right? You know, Stilo, who do you consider a friend in the game?
Friend in the game. Yeah. There's a lot of cats I consider a friend in the game. It would depend, man. I have timestamps. Like there's cats that have been my friends in the game for 15 years, 10 years, 5 years, 2 years. You know what I mean? So it's always like, and I mean, I consider Java a friend in the game, Zulu a friend in the game.
Got you.
There's a bunch of them, you know what I mean?
Got you.
The list. I think I consider most of hip hop.
Got you.
Friends in the game, you know what I mean? Because I'm one of those cats, like, I keep it a ticket.
I got you.
You know what I mean? Like, I don't buy face, I don't buy fame, I don't buy popularity. If I think it's whack, it's whack.
Mm.
And you just gonna have to live with that. Because at the end of the day, you have your own opinions about me, and I have to live with that. Not that I care, but that's just how life is.
Yeah. Mm. Yeah. I've heard a couple of artists that have a problem with that. You know, like that. You know, that. I guess you're very upfront. Like, for example, I heard Costa saying you once said he was performing something. I think on the come up, he's like, "Yo, this dude laughed at me, Steve."
Yeah, that shit was funny, Steve.
Okay, so a lot of people got a problem with that. Yeah. You know, people keep saying, but Stilo is this dude. Yeah. He's like,
that shit was funny. You know what I'm saying? Like, you know what I believe, man? Like, the reason I will never, ever, ever in my life live on my knees, ever in my life, is the fact that I'm honest with myself and I'm honest with everybody else around me. Do you know what I'm saying? Like, when I first saw Costa, the whole crew perform, they were performing Kentari, I remember that. The song they performed very much sounded like Mswengo Fontaine, like the structure of it. And like, it sounded like different, like everybody sounded like they were trying to recreate a verse on the song. So I was like, I think I was with Coolkat then, and I was like, yo man, doesn't this song sound like our song? And he was like, yeah, it kind of does. But we would, you know, we're drinking, we didn't care, you know, we laughed about it, kept it pushing. It's never been, it's not even beef, it's nothing. Inspiration, you know what I mean? Like, imitation is a form of flatter. What do they call it? Like, imitation is a form of whatever it is. So for me at the time, I was like, yo, that's dope. But also, for me, it's like, if your craft is one thing, like, we can never sit here in hip hop and say Costa Titch is a rapper.
But he
no.
He's inspired, but
he's an artist.
He's an artist.
not a rapper.
Still, I think you're gonna have a problem with that, bro.
We really rap, bro.
I think Costa would have a problem with that.
No, he's not a rapper, dog. He's an artist. The man is not a rapper. Yo, we really be rapping out here, bro. We really be rapping. Like, you're not gonna sit in a conversation and say, hey, Reese, you and Costa Titch are the same thing.
I think the context you put it in, be inspired.
Yeah, like,
but don't call and
it's not
based.
You see, the honest thing about me is that I'm not mad at dude. I like dude. I think what dude is interesting, it's necessary.
He's a performer.
He's, dog, that man was arguably one of the best dancers we've ever had, right? Arguably. But from turning the dance into the music thing, that's artistic. Right. That's definitely not to say he's a rapper. A rapper. Yo, cats be really rapping out here, bro. Also, mind you, like, if like, for me, if you're a rapper, you write your own shit.
Facts.
You know what I'm saying? If you're a rapper, you write your own shit.
And do people still care about that?
Hell, my nigga. Yeah.
Okay,
that's
but okay.
That's why we're rappers. That's why we're rappers, because we care.
That's one thing you can't
you
take
can
away
say
from
you
it.
Then you can say, no, but look at us, we're killing it, we're making numbers, we making bank. Yeah, but you still don't get the nod of a rapper.
That's, you know, it comes back to
that's cool.
Hey man, this conversation is
cool. Right.
Right.
For Costa.
Being a rapper, it's a flex.
Yeah, what do you mean? Yeah. It's like being able to speak different languages.
Got you. So who writes for Costa?
I don't know. I personally heard Phantom Rights.
Oh,
really?
And that's not even.
No,
yo,
Phantom Rights for
yo,
a
my
that's
nigga, not my nigga, my nigga. Kanye West
has got writers.
Drake got writers.
Got you.
You know what I'm saying? But it doesn't take away from the fact that they're actually rappers.
So can you be a rapper and let people write for you?
Dog, you can. The best musicians in the world have contributed.
Got you.
The best musicians in the world.
No, I agree.
Look at the credits. Those
you get what I'm saying? So that's why the man is a good artist. That's why the man is moving.
Stilo, you think this level of truth, bro, it burn bridges for you in the game?
Yo, my nigga, you don't burn bridges you're not trying to cross.
Oh.
Hey, that's just simple.
I think that's
the right. That's a big fix.
That needed that drop. Something like that.
Like, am I wrong? Am I wrong? I'm burning bridges I'm not trying to cross.
Yeah.
I got no business on that side of the pond, my nigga.
Yeah.
I'm good on the side of the pond.
Yeah. Nah, that's a bar.
Stilo,
man.
Give me three artists, bro.
That
if it were up to you, you bring back from the dead.
I bring back from the dead.
Yes, sir.
Nate Dogg.
Oof. Come on, let's go.
Brown Dash.
Oof.
Prince.
Prince.
Purple.
Yeah. But Prince, no, Prince is a legend. I'm not disputing. I'm just didn't think you'd say Prince. Yeah.
He just brought the ones that you can't argue.
That you no. Ah, you can't argue with Prince, bro.
Yeah.
You can't argue with Prince.
That's my trio.
Yeah. Yeah.
That's my trio.
Three wackest artists in the game.
Wackest? I don't know. I'm not checking for them.
Okay.
I don't know. If you know something, you know, that's bad.
No,
I feel sorry for you.
Hey man, I think it's
you
a lot.
You need to change your heart. There's too much hate in your heart. My nigga, I got no hate in my heart. I'm a real nigga.
Yeah. No, some hip hop shit like that. That nigga can't rap. Yeah. Awesome, nah, this nigga.
He ain't
this
rapping, nigga can't rap. Like, okay. Dog, we really be rapping.
Right.
We really
hell
be rapping.
Yeah.
All right.
That should be a song. We really be rapping.
We really out here.
Dog, you need to understand, dog. I come from the hardest rap crew to ever grace this land. The hardest rap crew. The hardest, dog. We are the hardest rap crew to ever walk these streets.
It's Boyz and Blxckie.
Yeah, the hardest rap crew.
Nah, y'all niggas.
Tell me who's harder.
Yeah,
what rap crew harder?
But
what,
and okay, hold on, okay, man, hold on. Of all time
Avengers.
In South Africa. Of all time in South
hardest.
Africa.
Hardest.
Okay,
I don't care.
Well, that's on 360.
That's no, that's not. I don't care what you say. We are
I
the
think
hardest.
We need a versus, bro. No, South Africa.
My nigga,
we need a versus. We need a versus.
My nigga, my catalog alone is hard. Riky's catalog is hard. Smiso's catalog is hard. And we haven't, dog. You must understand, Pubezi was rapping before us. he was an OG already. You got what I'm saying?
Gotcha.
So, dog, it's different conversations. He can argue with other OGs. He can argue with our OGs and say, yo, Amu can say, yo, we remember Pubezi from whatever ciphers and shit. Dog, hardest. We are like my crew.
No, look, I give your crew.
We're not even gonna talk about culture. We're just talking about rap.
Rap, got you. No, you guys.
If we talk about culture, then.
No. Boyz and Bugs, dog, used to run the game. How did the departure, Riky? How did you handle that, man?
Hey, man, it's revolving doors, you know.
Right.
Losing a brother is never easy. It's revolving doors, you know. It's like too much has happened too soon for me, you know. So it's never. It's an open wound. It's always gonna be an open wound. Like, that's why for me, I don't condone like a lot of the shit that I see happening online, you know?
What type of shit is that?
Just like, you know, just how people move around him.
Around the legacy.
Around the legacy, you know what I mean? That's not how you keep the fire burning. You know what I mean? You're bumping it down.
Mm-hmm.
You know? But to each his own. Because also he was I would say a street philanthropist.
Definitely.
So he gave back a lot. So a lot of people engaged with him for 2 minutes or like less than that and felt like they were a part of his legacy.
Facts.
You feel me?
Hmm.
So the interesting part about it is that, so what do you do with your 2 minutes that he gave you? So what are you gonna do with it, you know? I'm one of those people like, yo, I treasure the people I love. I try to protect them as much as I can from this fucking metaverse, this Jumanji of a game we're living in, you know what I mean? The zeitgeist we in. So when I see it, I'm like, alright, that's how y'all live, that's how y'all see it. That's chill.
You know? To correct the legacy, can we expect something like a Boyz and Bugs reunion? Even if it's just for like a tour, some dates, whatever.
You know what it is, dog. Me, I've learned, though, you can't force niggas to be something they never wanted to be. You know what I'm saying?
But hold on, Stilo. When you say never wanted to be, like, that's like from the essential.
Got to where it needed to.
Yeah, it happened.
Developed, yeah, into their own.
Because
selves.
You must understand, like, dog, Boyz and Bugs wasn't a thing. You see, like, you niggas can, like, together like this and say, yo, we a crew now. Must understand, Boyz and Bugs, everybody was dope when they met. I was a star already.
Gotcha.
You know what I mean? Like, I was killing my own shit already. You know what I mean? Smee was already touring overseas. Like, Riky was already doing his thing. Do you get what I'm saying? Like, MK was already lit. Like, everybody was doing their thing. So when we decided to do it, it's because everybody was popping and it made sense.
When did that meeting happen? Was it a meeting? Was it when it was like, okay, guys, we're doing this thing? Was
you
it
guys
a,
grew up together?
No, not necessarily grew up together. I think we can say grew up together in the
grew
sense
around
of,
each other.
No. We can say grew up together from a certain age.
Okay.
Do you get what I'm saying? Like, I think we in life you grow up, right? You have friends that you grow up with from zero, from like your baby to a certain age, maybe your teens or whatever, or your work, when you start working or get out of varsity, then you have cats that you grow up with from there on.
Gotcha.
You know what I mean?
The life.
So we all linked up. Like, for me, I linked up with the homies on my first, when I had my first job and I was working in Rosebank.
Gotcha.
You know what I mean? And the person who actually introduced, like, Riky and I linked up. Our friendship started separately outside of the crew. You know what I'm saying? And we linked up on our own shit. And then Mome introduced me to Coolkat and the other guys. And frankly, even when I first met them, I wasn't thinking they're my homies. I wasn't trying to be homies with cats, because generally I'm not that type of cat. You know what I mean? That's not
you
my
ain't
thing.
Trying to fuck with niggas.
That's not really my thing. Like, I'm just not really that type of guy. I'm not gonna lie. Like, anybody that knows me knows that he's not the guy that's looking to befriend you.
To befriend you.
You know what I'm saying?
But
we built a connection, we built a friendship, and it became a brotherhood, you know what I mean? But how we became Boyz and Bugs was just a matter of like, yo, man, everybody's winning. Let's unite this shit. Let's the Avengers shit. It was like, you're winning. Let's Avengers this shit. We can win more. And that's what we're doing. And we were killing it. Like, we were doing like crazy corporate shit. And that was before even the, like, before we were even publicizing the music like that, you know? So I think Boyz and Bucks was just it was easy for people. It was almost like a location to easier for people to pinpoint, oh, this is where you're from, this is what you're a part of, you know what I'm saying? But like my history thick, bro. You know what I mean? My history thick. Like, I'm like second generation, I'm a keep Boyz. I mean, we were throwing crazy parties back in the day. Like
first time I saw Mama Keep ever in my life, I think two people was Less and Homie.
Yeah.
I first saw it on Less and then I saw it on Homie. Yeah. I was like, this brand is fucking hot. Like, man.
That's where, like, yo, I was running with Les when he branched off from, like, so at the end of Josie into Deleuze's career.
Got you.
Like, yo, I was running with them cats. Like, yo.
Yeah, crazy.
But to be honest, shit. I think giving him his flowers, I mean, I don't think you'd ever meet.
I need a garden. Fuck around.
Hold up.
Give me a fucking
garden. Yo, Steve.
I want palm trees. I'm a tropical.
Palm trees, yeah. Baby.
Tropicana.
Tropicana.
Yo, sister, I just got one. I think it's a very important question for Stilo. So, on the song by Youngsta CPT, Dear Rikhado, I think he mentioned that he got on a call with you because there were people that just like couldn't really understand what he was going through at the time. Yeah. Like, do you mind sharing a little bit of how that conversation went?
Hey man, like, so me and Riyad, like, we were really tight, man. We were really, really tight. Like, we met at that point where, so nobody really knew him in the city, right? When I met him, like, nobody really knew him in the city. I used to stay in Parktown, and he was staying in Hillbrow. So, like, I'd go into Hillbrow and go to the spa or whatever. Gotcha. So I saw him the one time on the street, and I was like, yo, what's going on, homie? He's like, yo, what's going on? And he's like, nah, I'm staying out here, whatever. I'm trying to do this rap shit. Like, I'm doing this rap shit, obviously, but, like, I'm trying to do it out here, like really put in the work in Joburg. You know, because he's been doing shit in Cape Town, like mixtapes galore, you know?
Yeah.
And I was like, yo, man, we should link up, you know what I mean? Break bread, whatever, you know? Yeah. And maybe even get into studio. Then we started connecting. And we hopped into studio. We made posts like Stilo. We made Sleepers for the Rich, you know? And from then, like, and I say this with my chest, you know what I'm saying? From then, like, I always believe a lot of cats that come around me, like, first to a lot of cats in the game, they'll be like, nah, we don't want to mess with them. You know what I mean? They like that or like that. But then it's almost like I make it okay. Then other cats are like, oh, actually, maybe I could hop on this, like, street shit. Like, maybe it's not that scary. You know what I'm saying?
Still no intro to the street. Street don't know why.
Because after that, then all of a sudden, a lot of industry cats was trying to do stuff with Riyad.
Oh yeah,
you know?
Yeah.
And it had opened up, you know, and then boom, my man's moved, you know what I mean? And which was dope, and I was very happy for my bro, like, yo, do your thing. And he was up, he was moving. And then there was a time there was like a weird, like, just like, you know when people are in your ear talking crazy or whatever, and there was a lot of people like on his side talking crazy. You know
what's crazy?
Just like, you know, cats always trying to make it seem like there's beef when there's no beef. You know what I'm saying?
But I mean, you got his direct number. Nah, he can call you.
It's broken telephone. Like, even when you can call somebody directly, it's like Biggie could call Pop directly.
But it was never.
It was never. Even when he tried, it was never that easy. Like, it was always a problem, and that was the case. Like, it got to a point where it was like, yo, there was really some weird tension.
Damn, and bro.
And I'm for the thing is about me is that I'm a man first before I'm anything else.
Okay.
So I'm like, yo, if that's the energy, that's the energy. Right. You know what I'm saying? So I kept it a bean, and we kind of just, we weren't talking, and it was just whatever. then, you know, I think life happens, bro.
Yeah, in
life happens. Them. Life happens, and, you know, whatever, whatever. I think once or twice we spoke over the phone, but nothing like real, you know? And Riky happened.
Damn.
And I think Riky, like, another thing is that Riky would always be the person that would be like, he'll call me every time I make a new connection.
Mm.
Like, when I started hanging out with Riyad, he called me. Like, yo, I see you hanging out with Youngster, bro.
What's you on now? The plug to the streets.
What's
edge,
going
bro?
On?
Yeah, what's you on
now? Yeah.
What is this?
What are the missions?
What you on now? What's going on? You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And, you know,
word.
And he had maybe met him, like, once in Cape Town or whatever, but it was never like that. Because also, you must understand, like, what Boyz and Bugs, the main goal of Boyz and Bugs was making it okay for a kid in Alex to connect with a kid in Stellenbosch.
Gotcha.
A kid in Wamashu to be cool with a kid in Sanson.
Gotcha.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah. That's what we were breaking borders. For me, more than anything,
gotcha.
I come from the South, you know what I'm saying? Gotcha. To a 9-0. So for me, it was like, I have a lot of kids from across the borders on my back.
Gotcha.
That I represent. That you can't be xenophobic. Hmm. You know what I'm saying? Because we some giants. You know? And the thing is about us is that we some angry cats. Like, we grew up hard. Some cats have even thicker history than I do. You know what I'm saying? Like, some cats come from war-stricken spaces.
Facts.
You know what I'm saying?
Facts.
And they have that in their hearts, on their shoulders.
Facts.
You know what I'm saying?
And shout out to my director, Daryl. He comes from a rough pass, but he my nigga now.
You know what I'm saying?
We shining, like, we making money.
You know what I'm saying? Like, and that's what it was about. So, ultimately, like, with Riky, you always, like, whenever I make a new connection, even when I started hanging out with Big Zulu, nobody in hip hop was fucking with Zulu like that.
And I remember Zulu credited homie for the first time. Yeah. Him and MK.
Yeah, like, yeah, nobody yeah, was like, fucking with Zulu yeah, like that. Like,
yeah.
I was the first person to take Zulu to the clubs. He was
for
like,
real. Like, what the yeah, fuck happened here?
Like, I have pictures from
from Texas Rank. Rank to the club.
I have pictures.
Which
of
was
me
the
and
first
Zulu
club experience
too.
That you took?
Sumo.
Oh my god.
Yeah. So the pictures of Zulu in the club, like, we're in pictures, right? But Zulu's face is just like, what the fuck? Like, he was just like, he always like,
did he drink or was he?
Nah, he drink. Like, yo, me, like, we was thick every day.
Yeah.
But my thing has always been like, you know, if I fuck with your vibe and you're a cool dude, whatever, I'll kick it. You know what I'm saying? Like,
where you go, there you go.
Yo, for me, I'm a street guy. Like, I always believe, like, when it's all said and done, I'll be on the street. Yeah. I got family that lives on the street.
Got you.
Do you know what I'm saying? I got family, cats that, yo, I think we were toddlers together, that are now hobos in Brown.
Got you.
And there's nothing I could do about it. You can't, like, a person has repeated a cycle so much so that they can't be saved. You're going to put them in your system and they're just going to fuck your shit up.
Yeah. Got you. Brother, what happened with water? Let's go back to that, you know, clothing situation. What's going on with water?
Fire drip.
Yo, nothing happened to water. Water's cool, man.
Okay.
You know what I mean? Like,
where the drip at?
The, you know, we got water.
We need that for the podcast, man.
Yeah, but the thing is about water, right? I got this weird thing. Like, sometimes I don't like how it looks on niggas.
What
so
you mean?
What do you mean, dog?
Yeah. Yeah. But I get that with you.
How do you say, okay?
Like, that's like, sometimes I don't like how niggas be
niggas
rocking
this
shit.
Oh shit.
Right back.
Yeah.
So I'm just like, yo, I don't like
fuck
this.
These
so it's like sometimes it's just, that's why like I be like not so keen to push it out.
Okay.
You know?
Okay.
But water's always gonna be there. Do you know what I mean? Like, I make pieces from time to time, like,
yeah.
It's just like, for me, the fashion is like just like my passion projects. You know how people be making, like, all of a sudden everybody can paint.
Niggas expressing themselves.
Yeah, that type of shit.
I see where you're going with this.
I mean, you all can paint.
You all can paint that.
French fries. give us your
I think
your,
we Picasso.
Yeah.
Your last question that you might want to ask Stilo.
For Stilo.
Yeah.
God damn it, man.
I want to ask you a question.
Oh yeah, let's go.
Why are you thinking about it?
Yeah. Let me think about that.
I think it goes to both of you.
All right, all right.
Top 5 hottest MCs this year.
Top 5 hottest MCs. Blxckie.
1.
Lucasraps.
2.
KKeed. Who's been rapping, bro? Like
Magleradoeboy.
We had a nice. That's a hot verse. He had two hot verses. I love Maglera. I put pressure. You know, I'm hard on Maglera. You know why?
I'm a nigga hard on a nigga, bro. He's like, got a couple of dope.
You know why I'm hard on Maglera? Because I'm hard on Maglera because I know he can always do better. You know what I mean?
Mm.
And you're not going to have it soft like any of these other kids. You're from the gutter, gutter.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? You're the same responsibility I carry to a lot of these kids.
Mm-hmm.
In your own capacity, you carry the same. For your people,
literally.
So it's not gonna be easy for you.
Yeah,
right.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
Maglera, you don't look like Lucasraps. Lucasraps can decide to make R&B tomorrow, and it could work. He's a good-looking kid.
You can't do R&B.
Maglera's gotta go hard.
He's gotta go hard. Gotta go hard. Because he's representing the have-nots.
Yeah,
gotcha.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So a lot of people, sometimes somebody said to me, you always hating on Glera. I'm like, I'm not hating on Glera. Glera will tell you himself the first time he met me what I said to him. He bumped me some shit. It was years ago. He reminded me of this shit. I had a studio session.
Yeah.
It's only niggas that I think are not within the hip-hop. Not even niggas. I think it's people that are not within the hip-hop space that forget that it's a competitive sport. It's not always about who's beefing with what. Like recently, Lucas and them jumped on to when Ari said the what they assumed was the diss track.
Yeah, but how do you guys feel about, how do you feel about that
about the track?
About how do you guys feel about Lucas?
I love fire. Lucas.
Lucas can rap.
I believe in him. I love him. He's my nigga. I put my money in him, baby. Lucas is a motherfucker. He's a motherfucker. He's nice, dog. Yeah. He's nice.
He wants to surf on crowds and shit.
No, he's nice. He had a nice.
This kid really be.
No, he's nice. He's nice.
Dog, he really be rapping.
You're on three. There's two more. You're on three. You said I'll come to your fire.
Got you.
Two more.
Yeah.
Shit.
Who raps these days?
Who be rapping, bro? I already gave you a female rapper, right?
Yeah, mm-hmm. KKeed.
Shit. Damn, man.
I need yours quick, fast. Just keep thinking about it. Like no sweat.
I think for now is the top three. Because like, I got cats that I've always like love and put in high regard in terms of like raps.
Okay.
But yeah. I guess for now, that's that.
Word.
Let's go, French.
So for me, I definitely have Maglera there, mm-hmm. Doughboy, Tato.
Two.
Tato So.
No, 25K.
25K, come on now. Okay. Come on now.
I saw you'd remember that.
Come on now.
Kilo. Kilo, my nigga.
You can't take Kilo out your list, dog.
My nigga Kilo. My nigga
Kilo. Yomo's. Yeah. You know, you almost broke relationships there.
So, shit. I had Maglera and Tato.
Tato, so yeah.
I'm gonna put Youngsta CPT there.
Nah, that dude can rap.
Yeah,
homie raps hard.
I'm gonna put
this year.
Yeah, I mean, like,
nah, B, you gotta be specific.
Is it just, look, is it just for this year?
Are you saying all time?
No, this year, 2022.
Yeah.
I liked the Dear Rikhado song.
Yeah, but you can't, that was like, you can't, that's
the storytelling there was just like,
that's dope.
But bro,
that's raps, but you can't compete, you can't make it compete with these kids that are talking about.
All right, sweet.
You know what I'm saying? That's because he touched your heart.
But dog, he was
shit.
Dog, what?
You being an emo nigga.
Like, yo, Stilo, he a panelist for MTV Hottest.
A lot of people.
You know what I mean?
There's a lot of people that can't tell the story like that, though. You know what I mean? A lot of rappers can rap, but they couldn't tell the story, like, about how that situation touched them the way Youngsta did.
Okay, James, I'm a referee, dog. Let homie have his top five.
Wait.
Okay, Stilo, go at it. Go at it.
Because we're not putting songs out, don't mean we can't articulate our feelings, my
guy. Put them songs out, Stilo. Come on.
But it doesn't work like that.
Alright.
It doesn't work like that.
But I hear you,
though. You know what I'm saying?
I know what you mean.
Like, it's like, yo, my parents been gone for a long time.
R.I.P.
It's so hard to even I've been so many times I've gone in the studio trying to put the words down to express how I feel about that situation.
Yeah,
I can only put it in moments in songs because it's such a
deep
getting there. getting there is hard.
Yeah.
It's
yeah.
so fucking hard. You know what I mean? And not to discredit anybody else that's ever done a song about Rikhado.
Yeah.
But it's very hard for me to get there.
Mm. And do that.
See what I'm saying?
You believe eventually can you get there?
I will, but I've only gotten to a point where I know what type of joints it is.
Okay.
You get what I'm saying? Like, but it's not an easy task. Yeah, you know what I'm saying?
Mm.
But I understand exactly how Riyadh felt and how he got there.
You relate.
I relate. Exactly. But and one thing about him, he told me like, yo, this is like throughout Ramadan we spoke, you know, and he let me know like this how he's feeling, this was going on, boom, boom, boom. So I understood the space he was in that allowed him to get to that space and really communicate that letter. But it's like, it's hard for you to say now, yo, because it's sentimental. It's like
that should be on the.
Otherwise, you're telling us. And I love my brother. He knows that.
Word.
This is from a good place. But see you when you get there. But P. Diddy, you can't say that Diddy now is definitely in the running.
In the running.
That are running. That
nah,
are
saying, facts.
I'm the best rapper in Africa. You're the best rapper, but I'm the best rapper.
Nah, I hear you. So and in that case,
Aries. Yeah, yeah.
In that case, let's say
that's your five.
Let's take Youngsta out.
The last one was 25K and Aries. Yeah. Top five. Okay, cool.
Okay, let's take Youngsta out, right?
Okay.
So I'm gonna put Maglera.
Nah, I don't like Stilo. Stilo be influencing too much.
Nah, still. I hear where it comes from.
Yeah.
I hear where it comes from.
I got you.
Yeah. So
I want niggas to make honest opinions.
Let's go Maglera, let's go Tato, mm-hmm. let's go Aries, let's go 25K. Mm-hmm. I'm gonna go for Scummy.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Scummy's sick, but she's more she's sick, bro.
She's sick, yeah.
I've been hearing about her name. I've never heard of her.
Yeah, she's got that trap wave coming in, but like she's super talented. Yeah. So I'm gonna put Scummy there. Shout out to everybody else, bro. Blxckie, Lucas, everybody doing it. I miss Kitini. Kitini can freaking rap.
No, Kitini. I don't know what happened to Kitini, but anyway, that's a different conversation for another day.
He's got a trap.
Know what I mean?
Kitini's the guy from Ambitious.
Though. Ambitious, yeah. Is my bottle Ambitious?
Ambitious.
Oh, okay, cool. Yeah, no, he got the.
Oh,
yeah.
Oh shit.
Stilo, it's been such a crazy conversation.
Yeah.
I'm writing a book about your life. Give me the title.
A book about my life. I must give you the title.
Yes, sir.
Mbuzi.
Mbuzi. Goat. Yeah.
Straight
Mbuzi.
Up,
hey.
But it can't be. You can't put the word goat on it. It has to be
Mbuzi. Gotcha.
Yeah. And you know, every book needs a subtext.
Uh-huh.
Ibuzi.
Hey,
Word.
I think that's an album title, bro.
Hey, could be. Pondering around it, you know.
Really?
Mbuzi. Mbuzi. That's just because you know when I drop Mbuzi level. A lot of cats try to come at me talking about, you ain't the GOAT. I was like,
oh, you don't deserve it type of shit.
But I was like, the craziest thing about life is that you probably think I am the GOAT. That's why you were so quick to jump. That's why I'm not.
Why are you asking me?
That's why you were stressed.
Because
if you weren't stressed, like, you would have kept it like,
just keep it pushing.
Like, yo, this guy's crazy.
Guys.
You just kept it pushing. But, yo, man, yo, there's nothing better. There's nothing more incredible than coming into self, bro.
Yeah,
you know, and that's been just where I've been. Like, I'm diving deeper and deeper into self. Like, my shit, just like.
Gotcha.
Yeah.
We're halfway through the year, Stilo. What should we expect? I saw what you did with my papoos on my love.
Yeah.
This is a halfway mark. It's June now.
Yeah, I think I've just put out Jamila.
Okay.
I've been clocking like my all time feature list.
Mm. You know what I mean?
So did the my papusi joint, like homage to my papusi, one of the best like rhymers.
Let me tell you a quick story. My first album I ever had, three that I ever bought in my life as a kid, was Styling Gel Pitch Black Afro.
Yeah.
Classic. Mandoza 50-50, classic. My papuzi is inja. My love was on that.
Yeah.
Classic.
With the we had the velour.
Yo,
on the cover.
My nigga. Yeah, come on.
Different.
Different. That was the height of Kwaito.
Yeah.
That was special.
And now I just did a joint with Kabelo, which is
Kabelo Mabalan.
Yeah.
Oh yeah.
Unbelievable. Yes, Jamila is out now. He check that shit out. It's like videos out. It's crazy. Surreal experience for me.
Surreal experience, bro. Because this is 18 Shibo, but yeah, dog. This is like World Cup.
Yo, this is like
this is real life.
This is the first superhero we've ever experienced. Got like you. This guy went from being a superstar, like in a group, then did the solo thing, then did the drug addiction thing, then did the clean thing, then did the
church thing.
Now he's in the church thing.
Like running high level
dog, running Congress marathon and shit. Bruh. Two oceans marathon niggas here. White people nigga. Corporate. Danny Kiss. Yeah. Save South Africa. Rhino poaching. I'm like this nigga getting that corporate bag.
Coca-Cola first, you know, Danny K back to
my nigga, you bro, when I saw him with Danny K on some start Rhino poach, I'm like, this nigga gone. This nigga standing board somewhere there on winelands and shit.
Dog, like, yo, that man is different, bro. That man is
different. That's OG level.
Yeah. So yeah. I'm blessed to have a joint with him, and I just put that out. I just keep putting out music. I dropped another joint for my birthday, Balando.
Hey man, happy belated.
Last week. Yeah. Happy belated.
Yeah. Your birthday is the same day as Speedster.
I don't know. I don't know when Speedster's birthday is. I just know that my name is Michael. And that's what I know.
Yeah, I know. And that's a celebration with Boyz in the Hood.
Yeah. It was Boyz in the Hood was dope, but it was also like a little saddening for me. You know what I mean? Like, I don't understand why niggas in the hood just can't stop being so hood.
Dog, it's niggas in the hood. It's niggas in the hood, bro.
Yeah, I get that, but like, dog.
What happened? Okay, what happened on the day?
Cats was like, during my performance, I had to stop like 4 fights.
Oh, yeah. You know, it's not a party till somebody cap one in the air.
Bro, it was heavy. It was heavy. But, you know, we had fun.
Got you.
Response was great. Shout out to all the artists that came out.
Beautiful.
You know what I mean?
It's a beautiful lineup, man.
Yeah, you know what I mean? It's been a while since you've seen a predominantly hip-hop lineup like that.
Yeah.
You know? So, you know, it was dope. But we're doing another Boyz in the Hood on the 25th of June. Val Edition.
Val Edition.
Yeah,
right.
Val Edition.
My DMs podcast invite.
Come on now. VIP. We'll do something.
Let's go.
You know what I mean?
Let's go to the Val.
Hey, man. My director looking at me like 18. The time is up. So, one last question. And it's not for me. It's I want Stilo to look straight into that camera, right?
Yeah.
And ask hip-hop two questions that you've always wanted to ask. Hip-hop, the game, you're addressing them.
First question I like to ask hip hop is what you so scared of, you know? I think you need to stop being scared, you need to believe in yourself more. I think hip hop you need to be friendlier to your fellow hip hoppers, you know what I mean? Because I think also a lot of cats, you know, I'm always like I always like say things on top of things. But like I think a lot of cats came into this thing for the wrong way or for the wrong reason. Just because you rap doesn't mean you can't consume hip-hop as a culture, you know. Just because you do other elements doesn't mean you can't consume hip-hop as a culture. Like, consume hip-hop, learn hip-hop, you know, take care of her. My second question is why do we hate each other so much? Like, what is the deal? Like, why does my existence hinder your growth? Not even like, you know what I mean, not my success, because you don't know what I look, what my pockets are looking like. You don't know, you know. But why does my existence hinder your growth? And if you can answer that, if you can look in the mirror and answer that one question to yourself, maybe we can start moving forward.
I love you. First comment.
Yeah.
My nigga.
Yeah.
Hey, stuff like Nenga saying, I'm the best rapper.
Yeah. Yeah.
That's what makes other rappers like being with some hate vibes and energy.
Yeah.
On top of other rappers.
Yeah.
I wanted to hear your opinion about you're a rapper, you in this game, you know.
Yeah.
It's a competitive race. You can just come out and say you are the king of Jobbing and like just like that.
But you gotta, I believe Aries. He deserves it.
But I believe Aries
too. But like, I believe Aries in the sense of it that everybody can come out and say who they are. Who are you? And I'm saying, me, my name is my name, dog. Stilo Magolide. Magolide represents the city. And I carry the city on my back, but nobody was there for the city on this hip hop shit like I am. Do you know what I'm saying? Like, I'm the king of the South. I don't care who says what.
Come on now, talk
who
that
you
shit.
Vote for on the hip hop presidents?
Bro, for president, definitely me, because I was like,
but that's biased. You see, that's not, he's canvassing vote for himself. Vote for me.
Think about it like this, like, most hip hop cats, man,
yeah,
would be president and only make us listen to their shit.
Yeah, got you. Okay, so you
so you're putting people on.
Dog, I've been putting people on since the beginning of time.
Facts, word.
You know what I mean? Facts. Like, somebody needs, now we need some hip hop authors to write these books.
Right?
Facts.
And you know what I mean? Bro, nobody here writing here hip hop books.
Yeah,
and
we need
like
some of these. We need some of, you know what I mean? We need these bloggers to be telling the real
facts.
Stories.
Facts.
It's a hip hop reload.
Yo, we out here.
Yeah.
For sure.
Saying,
like,
yeah.
That's what
it's
we
connects. Important.
We're trying to do that now.
It's important.
For sure.
Like, it's important. Like, I was talking to my home in Kosana. Like for Mama Keep Keep.
Got you.
And we're like, yo, where we're at is that we need to take back the streets. And when I say take back the streets, is that the kids need to have a platform where it doesn't favor the platform.
Preserve the culture.
You okay, break me? It break that down more.
So it's like, if I'm a musician and I drop music on your platform, it mustn't be like your platform's doing me a favor.
Yeah,
okay. My music must move. Does your platform have people or not? Does your platform
real
have
people?
You understand what I'm saying? Like, don't put my shit on your shit for just data capturing and then send me links so I'm promoting your shit.
Word.
Because at the end of the day, when I post your shit, there's another kid that's looking and say, oh, that's where I must go upload my shit.
That's not it.
Like, what is the platform doing for the music? Not
basically
to say, hey, you must promote, but it must be a system that functions, that lives, and that's not biased.
So we need like a new age data file host. Remember data file host days, dog?
New age.
Hey, it was lit,
life.
Dog, that I time. Hip hop was alive,
wait,
dog.
You know what the craziest thing about what he just said is?
Yeah.
I didn't want to give too much information about what we were talking about. And that
he broke it down.
Literally.
He just said it.
Word.
No,
we spoke on data file host. Faraza is the biggest download what for music. Whether we like it
or not.
And ladies biggest. And gentlemen, my DM podcast is the biggest show on the internet. The Empire, baby. You know what it
word.
Is, how it is.
Are you also the biggest?
Ladies and gentlemen, hashtag male grooming. 10% my DM podcast with Fino. Use the code www.finocosmetics.com. Get all your male grooming, beard oils, shampoos, you know, bum control,
so
keep it clean. Keep
though.
It. No, me, dog. I've got a long chair here, bro.
You
got
to put French there. But
we're
going
to send it.
We're going to give you a little
shit natural.
Yes sir, my DM podcast, subscribe and comment. It was I think it's the longest episode ever, but it's the best. I think
we
struck the balance with this one between French Fry being a blogger and the knowledge and wisdom that Stilo Magolide comes through. Yes sir, we out.